Then, with great luck, our black cast came together and we could proceed with Ragtime. A complex, multifaceted show with difficult staging, lighting and costumes. But most of all, it was a story of human endeavour. Set in the year 1902, it follows three families from New York and their three very different worlds, all living within relative proximity to New York City. A rich, upper-class Protestant family from New Rochelle. The African-American community of Harlem, including a young woman named Sarah, with her shame as an unmarried mother. And Tata and his young daughter, immigrants coming to America from Latvia in search of a better life. These three worlds are at first connected by personalities such as Harry Houdini and Henry Ford. However, as time progresses and a new century dawns, these separate worlds begin to blur together, giving the nation a new syncopation. The people called it Ragtime.
You know me. you'll get here. Don't suppose I will. God has no excuses.
Over the 50 years that Milton Music Hall has existed, there have been repeats of earlier productions. Always a favourite is Fiddler on the Roof, with music by Jerry Bock, set in a Jewish settlement in Imperial Russia in or around 1905. The story centres on Tevye, the father of five daughters, and his attempts to maintain his Jewish, religious, and cultural traditions as outside influences encroach upon the family's lives. He must cope with both the strong-willed actions of his three older daughters, who wish to marry for love, and his own poverty.
Dear Lord, you have made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it is no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So, what would have been so terrible if I had a small fortune? If I were a rich man, all day long I'd pity, pity, boom. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a diddly rich, idle-diddle-diddle-diddle man, I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof and real wooden floor belong. There would be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down, and one more leading nowhere just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And each loud would light like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say, here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, all day long I'd diddy diddy bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Yabba dabba 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 dum. If I were a diddy diddy rich, idle diddle 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 man, I'd see my wife, my Golda, looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in the synagogue and pray, and maybe take a seat by the eastern wall, and I'd discuss the holy book with the learned men 7 hours every day. This would be the sweetest thing of all. If the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Won't it spoil some vast eternal plan? If I was a wealthy
Sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the years. Once season for
What words of wisdom can I give them? How can I help to ease their way?
Rodgers and Hammerstein have dominated the musical theatre, and there are too many shows to mention, but Oklahoma must rank as one of the best, as it was the first show of their collaboration. Set in farm country in 1906, it tells the story of farm girl Laurie Williams and her courtship by two rival suitors, cowboy Curly McLean and the sinister and frightening farmhand Judd Fry. A complex show to present, with some cast having firearms training, lasso lessons, and everyone having to learn the difficult American dialogue.
I got to Kansas City on a Friday. By Saturday, I learned a thing or two. Until then, I didn't have an idea of what the modern world was coming to. I counted 20 gas buggies going by themselves almost every time I took a walk. Then I put my ear to a bell telephone and a strange woman started in to talk.
What next?
Yeah, what?
What next? Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They've gone about as far as they can go. They went and built a skyscraper seven stories high, as tall as high as a little bit on the ground. Everything's like a dream in Kansas City. It's better than a magic lantern show. You can turn the radiator on whenever you want some heat. With every kind of comfort, every house is all complete. You can walk to trees in the rain and never wet your feet. Go.
Yes, sir!
They got
about as far as they can go. Everything's up to date in Kansas City. They got about as far as they can go. They got a big theater and they call it Brother Q. For 50 cents you can see a grand show.
One of the girls was fat and pink and pretty. I drowned her on and she was round below. When she began to peel, she proved that everything she had was absolutely real. She went about as far as she could go.
Yes, sir!
She went
about as far as she could go.
the chain.